Okay. See, ABC is an isosceles triangle with AB equals to AC. Okay. And bisectors of B and C, bisectors of the angle B and C intersect at point O. Okay, children. Then you join this O to A. Okay. Now we have to show first bit to prove OB equals to OC. Second bit we have to prove. Okay. Second bit we have to prove OA bisects angle A. OA bisects angle A. This one we have to prove. Okay. Now we are trying to prove OB equals to OC. Okay, children. So ABC is an isosceles triangle, right? So in isosceles triangle, angles opposite to equal sides are equal. That means angle B equals to angle C, right? This angle B equals to angle C, right? And this OB is the bisector of the angle B and OC is the bisector of the angle C. That means these two angles are equal, right? And these two angles also equal. Okay, children? And here see, since triangle ABC is an isosceles triangle, okay, angle B equals to angle C. Here I can write half of angle B also equals to half of angle C. Same number I can multiply on both sides, right? Now you observe in triangle OBC. Okay? Here you take this one is equation 1. Okay? So from equation 1, what we have? Half of angle B equals to half of angle C. Right? Here OB is the bisector of the angle B. OC is the bisector of the angle C. That means what is this angle and this angle? This angle is half of angle B because these two are equal to each other. That means only this angle is half of the angle B. Okay. So in case of half of angle B, I can write angle OBC. Right? And what about this angle? This angle also half of the angle C because OC is the bisector of the angle C. Okay, children. So here I can write OCB. Since OB and OC are the bisectors of angle B and angle C. Okay, children. Now you see here these two angles are equal. What is the theorem 7.3? What we had? Sides opposite to equal angles are equal, right? So I can tell what are the sides opposite to these two equal angles, OB and OC. So I can write here OB equals to OC. Since sides opposite to equal angles. Okay, children. So now we got OB equals to OC. First bit is that one only. We have to prove. Okay. Very easy. ABC is an isosceles triangle. That means angle B, angle C equal. Okay. And this is the bisectors. That means these two are equal to each other. Okay. When angle B, angle C equals means half of angle B, half of angle C also equal. These two also will be equal. When these two are equals in triangle OBC, automatically OB equals to OC. Okay. Now, what is the second bit? OA bisects the angle A, we have to prove. Okay, children. Now, you observe in triangle ABO, triangle ABO. When I am writing triangle, okay, you also observe the triangle where it appears, okay? And triangle ACO, ACO. Okay, children? In these two triangles, what we observe? AB equals to AC. It is given. AB equals to AC. Given. Okay? And what given? This angle also equals to this angle. Because this is also half of angle B. This is also half of angle C. Right? So, angle ABO equals to angle ACO. Given. Okay, children? Then, now you see, this angle equals to this angle. This one. Not. Sorry, we have to prove this one equals to this one, right? And we got OB equals to OC from bit number 1, right? OB equals to OC. Okay? OB equals to OC from bit number 1. Okay, children? So, by using these three conditions, side, angle, side, you observe, side between angle and one more side, okay, angle included between two sides, side, angle, side, by side SAS congruent rule, these two triangles are congruent to each other, right? So, therefore, triangle ABO is congruent to triangle ACO. By which rule? SAS rule. Okay, children? Right? So, these two are congruent. When these two are congruent, automatically what? These two are corresponding angles and these two also corresponding angles. That means these two will be equal or not? Equal. Okay? So, angle BAO BAO equals to angle CAO. Angle CAO by CBCT. Okay, children? By CBCT. That means what? AO bisects the angle A or not? When these two are equal, this ray bisects the angle A. Okay? That we will write. So, second bit also